Welcome to Play In School TV, episode 16. I'm Rich Prado. In today's episode, we talk about self-evaluation. The early response on the cheat sheet has been great. If you didn't download it, the link is in episode 15. So find the link for my cheat sheet to emailing college coaches over there. Okay, so one of the main reasons I started Playing School TV was it gives me a place where I can rant that is a little longer than 140 characters on Twitter or longer than a 7-second video on Snapchat. That's right, I'm on Snapchat. Be sure to follow me over there. Some good stuff going on over there from time to time, behind the scenes type of stuff at ball games, at college practices, at high school games, things like that. Today's topic is one that if you do follow me on Snapchat, I have been talking about a little bit lately, and I want to expand upon that. 7 seconds over on Snapchat just isn't enough. So let's talk about self-evaluation. Why is that important? And why should you as a ball player and a mom and dad and a coach think about self-evaluation? Obviously, the market that I'm in, every single kid that's in the showcase world has the goal of playing college ball. Problem is, I hear 7th, 8th, 9th grade kids who have this dream of playing college baseball. But some of these kids have never actually seen college baseball. That's why you need to get in the car and you need to drive over and see some games. See how do you measure up against the kid playing shortstop. So I would like to challenge every single player who watches this and every single parent who watches this to get in the car this weekend. I'm not talking about turning on the SEC network and watching ESPN's ACC games. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about getting in the car, going to a ball field near you. I don't care if it's a junior college game, a D3 game, a D2 game, a D1 game. I don't care. Go to a game, buy a hot dog, sit in the front row, and lock in on the kids playing your position. Do you have the range that that kid has? Do you have the arm that that kid has? Are you getting down the line the way that leadoff hitter is? Are you hitting the ball with the type of power that you're seeing those kids hit? This same rant can apply to parents. Parents are constantly telling their kid's coach how great their kid is, right? You hear that all the time. You say, well, have you actually seen a D1 game? No, but I know that my kid can play at fill in the blank. Yet they've never seen that program play or practice. All right, so parents, do yourselves a favor before you brag on how good your kid is and how he should be an All-American at a top 25 program. Get in the car and go see some games and evaluate these players compared to your player with open eyes. I will tell you one thing. I go to games of all levels. We have some unbelievably competitive D3 baseball here in the state of Virginia. I think I counted 4 teams that are currently in the top 25. This is legit baseball. This is very competitive baseball. So I urge players and parents, don't discount D3, okay? Go see the games and see where you fit in athletically. Okay, now we've come to coaches, all you high school and travel coaches. Now, a lot of you are doing a really good job. I see you on the sidelines on a Saturday and Sunday at the ball game. But a lot of y'all aren't. A lot of y'all play your 20 or 25 games. That would be against 10 to 12 to 13 different opponents. That means you get to see your shortstop, who's probably your best player, and you get to see 10 or 12 other shortstops who play for the other team. Coaches, do yourselves a favor. Go out and see college games so that you can effectively compare your player against the players who are currently playing in college. One of my favorite lines I've already heard from multiple coaches is when a high school or travel coach calls up and says that their player will definitely be an impact guy, play shortstop, hit third, do all those things. And the coach's response is very simple. It's, have you seen us play? And when the coach says no, the high school or travel coach says no, credibility goes down the tubes. So get out there. College games are a ton of fun. They're not expensive. You don't have to stay for 9 innings if you don't want to. I go, catch a couple innings, see a guy throw, see what he's looking like, see a couple ABs from kids I know, and then I head over. I'll sometimes hit 3 or 4 or 5 college games in a single weekend. So please, get out there, self-evaluate, stop dreaming, and start realizing truths, reality, real comparison between yourself and that kid at the next level who you want to be. Rant over. Please follow me over on Twitter, at Play in School. Please comment below in the comment section at YouTube. We'll put all the links below for you.